Hi guys, welcome back. We are on lesson 57, Saxon 8-7, second edition. Today we're gonna be talking about scientific notation for small numbers. These are things that are gonna be real tiny numbers. If I asked you to, what is the weight of an ant in terms of pounds? That would be like 0.00000001 pound, right? So instead of saying that, what we do is we use scientific notation, much like we do for really large numbers, like the weight of the earth. The weight of an elephant in ounces, like things like that are going to be really large numbers that we put into scientific notation. So I want you to be taking notes. These need to go into your journal. We're going to start with example number one. Let me move my book here. All right, hopefully I don't mess anything up. All right, so example number one says write 4.63 times 10 to the negative 8 in standard notation. So standard, this is scientific notation. So now we're gonna flip it around and do standard notation. Let me pause for just a sec. I gotta fix my light. Okay, thank you. Oh, my head's all right in the way. So that way you can see on the paper now, it's not as glary. I don't know if that works or not. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, like I said, standard notation, this is scientific notation, we need to put it in standard notation. The decimal is shown here. Again, if a number does not show a decimal, it's at the end. But in this case, it is. Now, for me personally, I like to write it right below, 4.63, because we are going to move it to the left. This number is smaller, so we need to make this number smaller. So we're going to move it to the left 8 spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which means we're going to put the decimal there. We need something to fill in here, so we're going to throw some zeros in here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 zeros. Now, don't just automatically assume that it's going to be 8 zeros. That's usually not the case. It's usually one less, but if it's in scientific notation, it should be one less, but not always. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 6, 3. Okay, that would be your answer here. Example number two. For this guy, we have 0.1234533 in scientific notation. Scientific notation. Remember, with scientific notation, we need our first number, this number right here, to be greater than 1, less than 10. So for me to move this decimal over, I would have to move it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 3.3, but notice how I made this number larger. It went from being 0.00000033 to 3.3, which is a larger number than before. That means I need to make this number up here smaller. That's where we get that negative. So we negative, I already forgot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, negative 6. Oh, the answer's right in front of me. Whatever. So that would be our answer here. Remember to box your answer or make it easy to find. Okay, so then let's look at example number three. This one says compare 0 to, put a little circle there, 1 times 10 to the negative 3. Well, straight off the bat, you don't have to put this into standard form to figure this out, because we know that negative 3 here, right, is going to be moving that decimal over. And remember what I said, if the decimal's not shown, it's at the end. So this would be a decimal here. Now, if I move it, I'm going to do 1. I'm going to start here. And I'm going to move it 3 spots. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. So I have 0.001 or 1/1000ths, right? Which is still gonna be larger than 0. The only thing smaller than 0 are negative numbers, and there's no negative number involved here. Yes, there is a negative number here, but that does not mean that it's gonna be in the front here. Okay, so the practice problems are on page 343. I would like you to do those at the top of your homework. Go ahead and give those a shot, and then come on back to make sure that you got those correct. Okay, so A is gonna be, all right, you guys, so I made it a little easier, paused and wrote the problems out first. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna move this decimal over. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We made this larger number larger, 2.5 times 10 to the, and because we made this larger, we have to make this smaller. So -7, okay? This one, we're going to move the decimal all the way over to the 1. So it's just going to be 1.0 if you want, or just 1. That's fine too. Times 10 to the, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 spots over. We made this number larger, so it's going to make this one smaller. All right. We're going to move this, we're going to move the decimal right in between here. So it's going to be 1.05 times 10 to the 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4, negative 4. All right, now we're going to go in reverse. What we want to do is 4.5. Notice I'm writing it all the way over here. When you're doing your homework, you might find that to be helpful because we have to go 7 spots over. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're going to put a decimal and we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros in there. Now 10 to the negative 3. So we're going to start with our 1. Our decimal is not shown, so it's at the end. We're going to go 1, 2, and 3. So we get 0.001 or 1/1000th in there. All right, so for F up here, 1 and 25 hundredths. Times 10 to the negative 5. So I'm going to take that 1.25 here, and I'm going to move this over 5 spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now I get 1, 2, 3, 4. That's kind of messy, so I'm going to rewrite it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.25. All right, we're going to compare these two things. I think it might be helpful until you get the idea of this, that you, in this case, we have a negative 3, which is going to make this smaller. That 1 is going to be smaller, right? This 1 is going to be larger. Both these have the decimals at the end. This is going to be 0.001 because we move that over 1, 2, 3 spots. This is going to be 1, 1, 2. We move it over in the other direction because it's a positive number. So we have 1/1000th or 100. Obviously, that one's going to be larger. Okay. You know what I just realized? I never did that on this part right here. So this is going to be larger. Sorry about that. My bad. Okay. So then on this guy, we have 2.5, and we're going to move that over. So 2.5, and we're going to go over 1, 2 spots. So 0.025. And then we've got 2.5, and we're going to go over 1, 2, 3 spots. So you can see when comparing, and remember for us to compare decimals, we have to have the same number of digits. I'm going to stack these two so you can see them as a comparison. 2.5.0025. I'm going to put a placeholder here so that you can see that. Now, when I do that, you can look at these. Once I have the same number of digits, we can get rid of this decimal, and we see it's 250 compared to 25. 250 is much larger, so this guy is going to be larger, because that's our 250. We threw an extra 0 on there. All right, guys, if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I will see you when we get back from, or when I get back, and I hope you have a good one. Thanks, guys.